Alcohol kills nearly 3 million people annually, the World Health Organization noted in a report it released last month. While the death rate had dropped slightly in recent years, Vladimir Puzyniak, the head of Alcohol, Drugs and Addictive Behaviors at the Department of Mental Health and Substance Use at the organization, said it remained unacceptably high.
The report also highlights that despite some reduction in the alcohol-related death rates since 2010, the overall number of deaths due to alcohol consumption remains unacceptably high and amounts to 2.6 million in 2019, with the highest numbers in the European region and the African region.
The United Nations Health Agency's latest report on alcohol and health said alcohol causes nearly 1 in 20 deaths globally each year. Through drink driving, alcohol-induced violence and abuse, and a multitude of diseases and disorders. The report said 2.6 million deaths were attributed to alcohol consumption in 2019, accounting for 4.7% of all deaths worldwide that year.
An estimated 400 million people, or 7% of the world's population aged 15 years and older, live with alcohol use disorders, with the highest prevalence in the European region, 10.7% of people aged 15 years plus, and in the region of the Americas, 10.2%.
In a similar report released last year by the World Health Organization, Uganda topped Africa in alcohol consumption. It revealed that, on average, a Ugandan consumes 12.2 liters of pure alcohol annually. Men were found to consume more than women, with an average of 19 liters of pure alcohol compared to 4.8 liters for women. Widespread access to hazardous crude oil luring young people into substance abuse has become a growing concern for sustainable development and accelerated alcohol-related problems in the country. It was against this background that members of parliament and the Minister of Health, led by the woman member of parliament for Toro, Sarah Opendi, sought to regulate alcohol under the proposed Alcoholic Drinks Control Bill 2023.
We want to reduce the availability of alcohol so that with specific times for drinking are agreed. Some of you, this place are young. Some of us who were there during Amin's time, you remember? During Amin's time, you could not go to a bar before, was it 6 o'clock or 5 o'clock? If they found you in a bar in the morning, they will arrest you.
They cause accidents. People drink the whole night up to morning. Today morning, I was going for my usual exercise. 6:30, along Akashi. So many bodabodas waiting for drunkards to transport drunkards away from the bar at 6:30 a.m.
The proposed law, among other things, aimed to consolidate all alcoholic-related laws and set tougher sanctions on alcohol consumption. However, this bill hit a snag, as alcohol manufacturers cautioned the government against passing it, claiming that it would likely crush Uganda's economy.
It's not availability, but it's abuse. It's like even non-alcoholic products. We are all worried about obesity. Is it alcohol causing it? We are worried about a lot of other things. So isolating alcohol, stigmatizing it as the only abused substance which needs to be controlled, we feel it's an overreach.
Global statistics on the fight against alcohol abuse remain alarming, and the World Health Organization notes that in order to achieve the reduction in line with the targets, include SDG 2030, concerted by countries to formulate regulations, and appropriate engagement for all relevant stakeholders.
Below the 18, not drinking will be emphasized. There is too much drinking, as my colleague there said, among young people. I have asked them, 5 years they drink alcohol, and you know, when we are growing, alcoholism affects our brain cells.